2 minutes to the start. 2 minutes to the start. Paddlers to the start area in your lanes, please. Paddlers to the start area in your lanes.
And this is where things start to get very interesting. This will be the kayak singles. 1,000 meter for men, semi-final race number one. In lane one.
First lane in this semi-final in the men's cable 1,000 meter. Alongside him, Zhou Yubo of China, Erik Ferras Larsen of Norway, the Olympic champion.
Rennie Poulsen,
very impressive in the heats. But as did the man outside him,
1 minute to the
start. Kuverden of Canada. Ben Furie of New Zealand goes in lane six. Bulgaria's Miroslav Kirchev.
Inside him.
Olympic reign may be coming to an end here. He's hanging in there. trying to push up in Kirchner. He's nearest to the crowd in the top of your picture there, Bravins. He will hear their noise most of all. And it's mostly for him. Vancouver and still out there, looking strong for Canada. But behind him, a fierce race is developing. It's the first four to go through to the A final. Only they will compete for the medals. And at the moment, Brabants with a finishing pole. It's so close between Brabants and Kirchev for fourth place. First is Van Kuverden. Second, Dennis Larson. And on the line, Brabants. It was close.
It certainly was close. He really pushed it down that last section using the vibe of the crowds. But I'm not sure it's going to be very tight.
Well, one thing is clear, Adam Van Kuverden is untouchable in first place, coming through fairly easily. Again, his main threat knocks off in the next semi-final. But who got that fourth place? Was it Brabants? Was it Kirchev, the Bulgarian?
There we see Brabants.
A roar from the crowd as we watch the replay. I think Brabants has got fourth place. We haven't had confirmation of it yet, the crowd have. Perhaps I'll shout across and ask one of them, but I think Tim Brabants has got fourth place and will be into the A final. No doubt about the winner, number one, Adam Van Kuverden. Still, we await confirmation. The suspense is killing us, but I think that cheer from the crowd, which is 98% British, will tell you that Tim Brabants, the defending champion, is through, unless I've misread it massively. Shouldn't be an entire surprise, but Adam Van Kuverden, here is the result. Tim Brabants is through, and look how close it was between Brabants and Miroslav Kirchev, right on the line, but Tim Brabants, the defending champion. Well, I don't think he's going to threaten for a medal in that final, but just to be in that final as the defending champion is quite an achievement with all the injury problems he's had with his shoulder, with his pain.
He certainly had a really tough 2 years. Came back after having 18 months out of sports in 2010 to claim the silver medal at the World Championships, but since then was struck by a real serious pec injury involving an operation, and has been trying to make a steady comeback since. So he'll be really pleased to have got out there, nailed the semi-final, which was really the big race for him this morning, and then to be in the final for Wednesday.
Realistically, that was Brabant's goal, to get into the A final, to be there when it's all settled, and when eventually he has to hand over his Olympic crown. But just to be in the final, he still has a chance, an outside chance of a medal. But my goodness, Adam Van Kuverden of Canada has been very impressive. Semi-final, we'll see. Even with the efforts of Adam Van Kuverden so far, the man who is the favourite match off, perhaps alongside Anders Gustafsson as well, both are very, very impressive in their opening heats.
They certainly did, and Anders is a training partner of Adam's. He spent a lot of time in Florida working hard together, invite the odd person in here and there, so they know each other's race plan. And in the heats this morning, we did also see him coming out really hard, leading, dominating his heat. But Max Hoff is a really high caliber athlete, and be determined to go out there as well and make his mark.
It's Ali Yerenya from Belarus. He's also a prospect for the medal. He's played in the World Championships. Gustafsson.
We have 1 minute to the start.
Max Hoff, though, this giant man from Troisdorf, just outside Cologne, 6'6", European champion for the last 4 years, 9700. Mrabet goes for Tunisia. Fast finish.
Headers to the start line, please. Line four forward, please.
First round. Maurice Stewart, also racing in the K4 1000 metres. Finished second in the World Cup event in Moscow last month. There's some pedigree here, but as it was in the first semi final, first four go through to the A final, the remainder into the B final.
Hold your positions there, please. Hold your positions there.
Start.
set.
As they come up to the line now, it is Max Hoff and Ali Urenia. Hoff takes it from Urenia. And coming through in for Gustafsson was there. We'll have to wait confirmation who got that fourth place to settle the first four through to the A final. You see what's taken out of Max Hoff. There was a little bit left in the tank in the first round, not so in the semi-final. As he came through to take it from Ali Urenia. And Anders Gustafsson there for Sweden.
There we have it, real power that gets thrown through these German arms of Max Hoff. Knees pumping. And the grimace on the face of this very fine push to the line.
Away of confirmation here in our commentary position of the first four. Max Hoff is there, Ali Urenia, Anders Gustafsson, and Francisco Cubelos Sanchez just taking it from Garcia on the line by fractions.
London is the first city that hosts the Olympic Games three times. The first was in 1908.
And there is the ultimate confirmation of that.
And the third is, of course, right now.
Hoff, Urania, Gustafsson, and Cabellos Sanchez go through to the main final, the A final. The rest go into the B final. Money Stewart missing out despite his early promise in that race.